Hello, my name is Andrei, and I'm an embedded software engineer at Alauda. At Alauda, we design a vehicle with multiple sources of information for state estimation and localization. For example, one such a system is satellite navigation. Each vehicle has a double GPS setup, which allows not just to provide redundancies in the system, but also to calculate a heading angle. In addition, we have a ground station which transmits correction messages which allow to correct for common errors occurring in current satellite navigational system. The whole setup allows to provide accuracy of centimeter level to all the vehicles participating in a race. This is useful not just because it allows to track all the speeders on a track, but also to provide obstacle avoidance functionality. We can have multiple vehicles participating in a race, and each vehicle should be aware of all the other vehicles' positions. Satellite navigational system allows to get accuracy about 1 meter. However, if you place a fixed station on the ground, you can transmit correction messages over the network, which allows to improve accuracy to centimeter level. Even though there will be multiple cameras on each speeder which allows to detect, identify and avoid the obstacles, it's still very useful to be aware of all the positions of all the other speeders. Apart from user cases during the race, we can use GNSS system for localizing speeders during the testing. It's always useful to have an ability for speeder to follow the predefined track. This might allow us to verify that all the systems are behaving as expected during the flying through the predefined route and provide repeatability for the experiments. Even though pilots are expected to maintain control over the vehicles at all times, it also comes down to safety concerns. If for some reason a pilot is losing control over the vehicle, he can trigger home return function, which will return the vehicle to the home position safely.